Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will learn about how to design a coagulation, flocculation, and clarification system. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's begin by the design considerations of the coagulation tank. Concerning the detention time for coagulation tanks, it's between 20 and 60 seconds. So, what does detention time mean? It means that the water has to stay within the coagulation tank for about 20 to 60 seconds. Now, if you are using an inline mixer, no need for this tank. An inline mixer is a mixer that is within the piping system. The detention time will be between 1 to 5 seconds. Now, to find the volume of this tank, you will have to use this formula, volume equals to Q times T. Q is the flow capacity and T is the detention time or the retention time. The mixer speed, so this is the mixer. It's flash mixing, or it has to be rapid or quick. And the mixer type could be inline, could be turbine, propeller, or a paddle mixer. Now, for the flocculation tank, the detention time is much higher. It's between 20 to 60 minutes. The volume of the tank is also V equals to Q times T. And here we are using a slow mixing. And the mixer type must be a paddle mixer. For the clarification tank, the detention time is between 2 to 4 hours so that the flocs can have enough time to settle down. The volume of the tank is V equals to Q times T, and here also Q is the flow capacity and T the retention time. Now let's see a practical example of how I can design an alum solution tank. We have to design a concentrated alum solution tank for a water treatment plant that has an average flow rate of 10 meter cubes per day. The alum dose is 40 milligrams per liter, and we can get this value using a jar test. And the alum concentration is 10%. Now, what we are doing here is designing this solution tank that is filled by the alum solution, which is the coagulant that we will be using. And this is usually pumped to the pipeline. And we are designing here the volume of this tank. So what's the volume of the tank? Now, first of all, we will fill this solution tank once a month. You can choose to fill it once a week. But in this example, we will be filling the solution tank every month. So that's why we will have to convert the 10 meter cubes per day into months. So meter cubes per month. We will multiply it by the average days per month. It's 30.5. So 10 times 30.5, it will be 305 meter cubes per month. So we are treating 300 meter cubes of water every month. Now, the amount of powder alum will be 305 times 40, which is the alum dose. We will get 12,200 grams, which is equivalent to 12.2 kilograms per month. The monthly amount of alum solution will be 12.2 divided by the 10%. So we will need 122 kilograms per month. So So here you will have an idea also about the cost of the alum powder. We know that the alum solution specific gravity is 1.3 kilograms per liter. So the monthly volume of alum solution will be 122 divided by 1.3. So the volume of my tank will be 93 liters. Now concerning the design of the flocculation tank, we have chosen a detention time of 50 minutes. We will convert the flow from meter cubes per day into meter cubes per minute to be consistent. So it will be 10 divided by 24 times 60. And we will get 0.007 meter cubes per minute. Concerning the volume of the coagulation tank, it will be V equals to Q times T, 0.007 times 50, 0.35 meter cubes or 350 liters. This is concerning the flocculation tank. Now concerning the design of the clarification tank, which is the sedimentation tank, the retention time we have chosen 3 hours. So QD is 10 meter cubes per day divided by 24, 0.42 meter cubes per hour or 416 liters per hour. And also here we have to use the formula Q times T for the volume. 416.36 times 3, so the volume of the clarification tank will be 1,250 liters. If you want to learn more about water treatment, you can take the Water Treatment for Beginners course on Udemy. You can find the link in the description below.